friends, welcome to Greater English YouTube channel. Today we are going to talk about a poem, Lucy Gray, written by William Wordsworth. Friends, first let us talk about the poet Wordsworth. William Wordsworth was a great English romantic poet. He is considered to be the pioneer of English romantic movement in English literature. He got this credit with the publication of Lyrical Ballads, which he published jointly with S.T. Coleridge in 1798, and the revised edition of which was published in 1800. Wordsworth wrote 387 poems during his lifetime. Some of them are The Prelude, Tintern Abbey, Lucy Gray, Daffodils, and so on. Wordsworth is also known as a lake poet. The reason being, the place where he resided was surrounded by wild, beautiful landscapes and numerous lakes. The mention of all these natural objects are found in the poems of William Wordsworth. Wordsworth was a poet of nature. His poems are replete with emotions and imagination. According to Wordsworth, poetry is a spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings recollected in tranquility. Such tranquility and such emotions are found in abundance in the poetry written by William Wordsworth. Moving on to the poem Lucy Gray. Lucy Gray is a ballad. Now, what is a ballad? Ballad is a simple, spirited poem in short stanzas narrating some popular story. Lucy Gray is a lyrical ballad published in 1799 at Goslar in Germany. The story of the ballad is based on an actual incident narrated to Wordsworth by his sister Dorothy. The poem is also known under another title called Solitude. In the poem Lucy Gray, Gray is representative of Lucy's isolation, her staying away from companionship, and she being a solitary girl. The poem is divided into 16 stanzas. Let us analyze the stanza one by one. Moving on to the first stanza. Oft I had heard of Lucy Gray, and when I crossed the wild, I chanced to see at break of day the solitary child. The poem is about a small girl, Lucy. The speaker claims that he saw Lucy, the solitary child, at the break of day. No mate, no comrade, Lucy knew. She dwelt on a wide moor, the sweetest thing that ever grew beside a human door. In the second stanza, the poet says that Lucy had no mate, no comrades, no friends. She lived on a big marshy land, wild moor. She was a very sweet, darling girl to grow around the human cottage. You may spy the fawn at play, the hare upon the green, but the sweet face of Lucy Gray will never more be seen. In the third stanza, the speaker says that you may catch sight of a hare upon the green meadow, but the sweet face of Lucy Gray will now never be seen. Tonight will be a stormy night. You to the town must go and take a lantern, child, to light your mother through the snow. In the fourth stanza, Lucy's father suspects that the night would be very stormy. He therefore asks Lucy to take a lantern to the town and guide her mother on her way back home. "That, father, will I gladly do. It's scarcely afternoon. The minster clock has just struck two, and yonder is the moon." Lucy tells her father that she would gladly go to the town. It was just 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and the moon was also quite far. This means that there was still time for the evening. At this, the father raised his hook and snapped a faggot band. He plied his work, and Lucy took the lantern in her hand. The father raised his hook, which is a type of agricultural equipment, and faggot, that is bundle of firewood sticks, and returned to work. Lucy took the lantern in her hand and started for town. Not bitter is a mountain road, with many a wanton stroke, her feet disperse the powdery snow that rises up like smoke. Lucy starts walking along carelessly, that is blithering, kicking up the powdery snow and watching it rise like smoke. The storm came on before its time. She wandered up and down, and many a hill did Lucy climb, but never reached the town. Lucy was on the way, but the storm came on before its time. Lucy wandered up and down, climbed many hills, but she never reached the town. The wretched parents all that night went shouting far and wide, but there was neither sound nor sight to serve them for a guide. At some point during the night, Lucy's mother returned home. But when Lucy did not come back, the parents became very upset. They went shouting far and wide, but found nothing in the darkness and silence of the night. At daybreak, on a hill they stood that overlooked the moor, and thence they saw a bridge of wood, a furlong from their door. Now there is a daybreak. Lucy's parents stood on a hill and looked through the moor, that is wide area of countryside. At that time, they saw a wooden bridge which was hardly a furlong far from their house. They wept, and turning homeward, cried, "In heaven we shall all meet." When in the snow, the mother spied the print of Lucy's feet. The parents suspected that something wrong had happened to Lucy. They started weeping. They gave up their search for Lucy and returned home. They hoped that they would meet their daughter only in heaven. However, the mother suddenly saw the footmarks of Lucy. They downwards from the steep hill's edge, they tracked the footmarks small, and through the broken hawthorn hedge and by the long stone wall. The parents come downwards the steep hill's edge. They continue to track the small footsteps. They walked along the broken thorny bushes and a long stone wall. And then, an open field they crossed. The marks were still the same. They tracked them on, nor ever lost, and to the bridge they came. The parents crossed the open field and saw that the marks were still there. They tracked them closely and reached the bridge. They followed from the snowy bank those footmarks one by one into the middle of the plank, and there were none. The parents were following the footmarks one by one, but as soon as they reached the middle of the plank on the bridge, the footmarks stopped. This means that Lucy fell off the bridge. This stanza invokes the feeling of intense loss. Yet, some maintain that to this day she is a living child, that you may see sweet Lucy Gray upon the lonesome wild. The speaker reveals that the body of little Lucy was never found. People therefore continue to believe that Lucy is a living child. They also claim that she can be seen upon the lonesome wild forest playing happily. Over rough and smooth, she trips along and never looks behind, and sings a solitary song that whistles in the wind. The last lines of the poem strengthen the belief of the small and simple hill folk that Lucy Gray is still alive. The speaker suggests that Lucy trips along and never looks behind as she sings a solitary song. Lucy underwent the transition from a human being to a spirit that is free to roam in the beauties of nature. Now coming on to the concluding remarks. Lucy Gray is a typical lyrical ballad written in Wordsworthian style. It's written in simple, ordinary language. Rustic life in close proximity with nature is presented in the poem. Wordsworth believed that far from the debasing influence of urban mode of life, rustic folk express themselves more instinctively and spontaneously. The poem ends at a philosophical note where Wordsworth believed that death is a transition from one state to another. According to him, nature is omnipresent and it will accept everyone. This is all about the poem Lucy Gray. Hope you have understood the poem. Keep studying. Stay blessed. Wish you all the best, dear students.